Manfred! Manfred! Anybody home? Hi there, Manfred.
Who is it?
Scott. Scott Shelby. Do you remember me?
Scott? This is Scott! Oh, yes, of course. Well, good to see you. How long has it been?
Oh, about 10 years, I guess.
It's a long time.
At my age, time means nothing anymore. I repair clocks, but I try to forget about time. How about you? Are you still with the police?
Oh, no, I quit. I'm a private investigator now. This is Lauren. She's a friend.
Hello.
Oh, hello, young lady. Well, this calls for a celebration. I've just the thing. Wait there. I'm sure I saw a bottle of scotch around here somewhere. Do an old man a favor, would you, Scott? Tell him to call back this afternoon.
Sure, no problem. Hello? Yeah, this is Manfred. He's not available right now. Could you call back later this afternoon? Thanks.
Well, to old friends. Cheers.
I'd like you to have a look at an envelope. I thought maybe you could tell me about the typewriter that was used to type the address on it.
Well, let's have a look. Now, could you pass me the magnifying glass from behind the counter?
Oh, sure,
please?
I'll get it.
My eyes are beginning to fail me. Thanks. Well, let's see what this envelope has to say for itself. A Royal 5. Yes, the shape of the T's and the F's is typical of that model. Produced between 1907 and 1924. Yes. No doubt about it. It's a Royal 5.
These typewriters, are they rare?
No, they're fairly common. I'd say many folks have one gathering dust in an attic or in their cellar.
Are there many places around that could repair one of these?
I bought the company's entire stock of spare parts for a song in 64. Well, they were going to take them to the dumpster, so I got the lot. Well, anybody around here who has one that actually works has been to see me at one time or another.
Do you keep a record of all your clients?
Oh, yes, indeed. At least the ones who pay.
Any chance I could get a peek at that?
Yes, of course. I keep my account books in the office. If you're not in a hurry, I have a list of all the clients who ever bought a Royal Five or had one repaired.
Yeah, that would really help us out.
Delighted to help. Give me 2 minutes, and I'll be right back with the list.
You think the killer's been here?
If he has a 1920s typewriter, he may have needed Manfred's services to get it fixed. We'll know when we get the list.
Killer's name might be in Manfred's papers. Been a while since Manfred went into his office. I should take a look. Lauren thinks she's about to find the killer. I'm afraid she's going to be disappointed. Been a while since Manfred went in.
Hello?
Manfred!
Hello? Your call is lost, sir. A police car will be there in a few minutes. I need to know who you are, sir. Sir? Hello?
Oh, my God. He's dead. Oh.
The killer has already called the police. I think he wants us to be his scapegoats. We gotta get the hell out of here.
What do you mean? We have nothing to do with his death. We were just here when it happened.
Look, we're running out of time to find Sean Mars. The last thing we need is 24 hours in a police station explaining this whole thing.
Well, so what do we do?
Watch the front door. I'll get rid of our fingerprints from everything we touched since we came in. We better work fast. The police are going to be here any minute. What are you doing, Lauren? If someone comes in, we're going to be in trouble.
These are Manfred's account books. He must have been looking for owners of Royals when he was killed.
Forget it. We got to get out of here fast.
I'm almost finished. That's it. We're done.
You get all the prints?
just check one last time. I haven't forgotten anything. That's it. We're done.
You get all the prints?
I got what I got. It should be enough to prevent them from finding us. Come on, let's go.
The victim was killed while you were in his shop.
Yes, he went to get something in his office. A few minutes later, I went in to see if he was okay. That's when I found him.
You should have called the police immediately, Mr. Shelby. Would have saved us dragging your ass down here.
Listen, we had nothing to do with his murder. We were only there by coincidence. I just wanted to spare myself a few hours declaring I didn't see anything to a police officer.
P.I. or not, Mr. Shelby, don't leave town. If you end up next door to any more dead bodies, remember to call us. Okay?
Well, well, Scott Shelby. Trouble again?
Wrong time, wrong place. You know what it's like.
Don't sweat. I'll take care of it. For old time's sake.
Thanks, Carter. I owe you one.
You on to anything at the moment?
Well, I got some ideas. Nothing concrete.
Goes beyond the idea stage. Tell me about it, will you, Scott?
Sure.
Where are we going?
I'm taking you home. This is getting way too dangerous.
No way. We're partners, remember? We had a deal.
Listen, Lauren, I know you want to find the killer, but you're not helping me by putting yourself in danger.
I'm not a child. I know what I have to do. I've got to find my son's killer. You're not going to stop me.
Well, then you can find him without... I refuse to be responsible for anything that goes wrong.
Stop the car. Stop the fucking car!
Crap, I have no choice. I guess I'm doing this to protect her. This girl's stubborn as a mule. She doesn't let up, with or without me. Can't just leave her like that.
I miss him. I miss him so much. I'd do anything to hold him once again in my arms.
Yeah? What do you want? Fuck it. I said 1,000 times that I don't want any junkies in my door. If you want to score, man, you gotta fucking call first. Come on. Beat it. Take it easy, man, huh? Keep cool. What do you want? Dope? Money? Tell me what you need. I'm sure we can make a deal, huh?
Gosh! I'm gonna blow your brains out, you son of a bitch! You think you're coming to my house to steal my dope? You're gonna shoot up in hell, motherfucker!
Will you stop fucking moving? No way to hide, dumpy asshole.
Man, I give you whatever you want. Got dope? Got cash? You want some dope? Please. Please don't kill me, man. I got children. These my girls, see? This one's Sarah. And a little one. That's Cindy. Please, man. I want to see them again. Please, please don't shoot.
I'm a father too, but I have no choice.
Thank you. Matt, it's Sam. I got your information. The owner of the apartment in Marble Street is a Dr. Adrian Baker. He's a struck-off surgeon. He used to sell drugs to junkies on the quad. He made some cash and bought up some cheap-ass apartments, including the one in Marble Street. Of course, he got caught. He did a few months in prison and was struck off the medical register.
Interesting. Thanks for the information, Sam. I owe you one.
Hey, Matt, be careful, okay?
I'm on it. Talk to you later. The owner of the apartment where Ethan cut off his finger lives here. It's not much of a lead, but it's all I've got. Hi. I was told that you could get Bitropin. Without a prescription?
Sorry. You were misinformed. Goodbye.
Hold on. I really need your help here. I can pay.
Well, why didn't you say so? Please, come in.
So, you're looking for Bitropin, my dear. Are you having trouble sleeping? How much do you need?
I don't know, about 3-4 boxes.
Well, no, that shouldn't be a problem. Would you like a drink? I was just about to have one.
No, thanks.
Well, alcohol helps take the edge off the pills, don't you think? Anyway, we should drink a toast to our first deal. I haven't seen you around here before. Who told you about me?
It's a tight neighborhood. People talk. I heard you had some apartments for rent. I'm looking.
Sorry, darling. Those are all booked up.
Shame. I was looking for something around Marble Street.
You're not drinking?
Yeah, sure I am.
Having some trouble. Didn't your mother ever warn you about accepting gifts from strangers? To Matthew. He claimed he had come for the census. Another one of those goddamn government spies. So, you're interested in my Marble Street apartment. I rent it to my friend Paco, if you must know. I have no idea what he does there. Maybe that's where he fornicates with his dancers from the Blue Lagoon. To be honest, I don't give a damn. Just as long as he pays his rent, he can do whatever he likes. But enough with the chit-chat. I miss surgery, you see, so I take every opportunity to practice. I don't have any instruments here, so I use whatever comes to hand. I hope you won't hold that against me. Hold on. This might sting him.
As soon as you start to do a little housework, someone always comes calling. I'll get rid of our visitor and be right back. Don't move. I won't be long.
Hello, sir. I come to bring you the word of the Lord in the form of these magnificent Bibles, which I will gladly leave with you, in return for a contribution of only $5.
No thanks, I love it.
Come now, brother. I cannot believe the word of the Lord is of no interest to you. We, his humble flock, should walk in his steps, for St. John has said...
Thanks a lot, but I don't need anything.
Who does not need a Bible in these times of violence and hatred? Holy Scripture will bring you peace and tranquility anytime you need it. All from here, $5.
No Bible for... Bible.
Thank you.
Goddamn rain. Soaking wet. 24 hours. I've got less than 24 hours if I want to find Sean Mars still alive.
Hey, Cracker! What you doing in there?
Norman Jaden, FBI. Can we talk for a minute?
Yeah.
I'm looking for the owner of a blue Chevrolet Malibu 83. I don't give a damn how the car got here, or whether you stole it or not. I just want to know who bought it from.
Sorry, man. Don't ring a bell. I got a real bad memory of names.
Perhaps I can help you to remember. If we find out that you sold the car to the man we're looking for, you're looking at some pretty solid time inside, Jackie boy.
You trying to scare me with your big talk? I never saw your damn car. Now take a walk.
The blue Chevrolet is my only lead. Not much help, this so-called Mad Jack. He's either clean as a whistle, or else he's got something to hide. Blood.
What's up, man?
Why is there blood here?
Healing animosity? Is that how you feel? How are you?
Fingerprints. Probably Mad Jack's. Size 10. Most likely a visitor. Size 13. Must be Mad Jack's size. Harry, comment. Traces of orchid pollen in the air inside the garage. Same brand of tire as the car I'm looking for. Is the killer's car being here? Few traces of blue paint, same tire tracks. No doubt about it. Killer's car was here.
Not the car I'm looking for. Not the right car either.
One of your cop buddies asking too many questions. I had to solder up his little mouth. Hands on your head, pig. I ain't got time to be playing around with you. Let's just get you out of sight and finish you off.
Around. Now you're gonna tell me about the man with the blue car.
Go fuck yourself in the ass.
Last chance, Jack. Make it easy on yourself.
What you gonna do? You ain't got them killer eyes, so what? You gonna cuff me?
I've no time to lose, Jack. I wanna know who that car belongs to.
What you want don't mean shit to me. I ain't no snitch. You better just lock me up now, boy. Damn! You out of your motherfucking mind, man?
Oh, shit, Jack. Ain't nothing to it. Just a little bit of self-defense. Page one of the police manual. Kill or be killed.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Stop. Enough. I'm starting to remember some things. You be cool. I'll tell you the tale. No, I don't know nothing about the guy. He wanted me to get rid of his dirty car. Get him a new one with false plates. He paid cash. And I ain't the questioning kind. Said I was supposed to drop the word to a guy named Paco down at the Blue Lagoon when the car was done. Now that's all I know.
We'll continue this discussion down at the station. You're under arrest. You have the right to remain silent. Anything... Shit, not now. Anything you say can and will be...
Hey, you look like you got a problem, man.
So, you think the origami killer killed Manfred?
That makes sense. Didn't want him spilling his guts to us.
And you suspect Gordy Kramer, right?
Oh, him or one of his men. Gordy has the time and the means, not to mention the fucked up attitude to go along with it. He's only a suspect, but he's a pretty guilty looking one.
Are these your files on the case?
Yeah, I've been working on them for a couple years. I built up a mountain of paperwork.
Magazines about origami? You think the killer could have subscribed to one of those?
If he was even remotely interested in origami in the last 30 years, his name may be in there somewhere. Trouble is, there's over 500 names. It gets a squat.
I'm starving. Do you have anything to eat?
Well, I'm no chef, but I should be able to make some scrambled eggs if you like.
Great. I'm soaking wet. I need to warm up a little. Is it okay if I take a shower?
Be my guest. Go in my bedroom. It's the next door. Oh, I'll cook up the eggs while you're under the shower.
Eggs should be ready by now.
Those are some weird looking eggs.
I took the liberty of borrowing your bathrobe.
Looks better on you.
Hey, that almost looks good enough to eat.
What's that?
The notebook I took from Manfred's place. According to this, about 30 clients bought spare parts for Royal Machines in the last 10 years. The killer may be one of them.
Oh, you know, checking out the alibi of 30 clients, one by one, that's a lot of legwork.
Except that if we cross-check them with the list. The list of subscribers to Origami magazines. You still got that, right?
Yeah, of course. But Lauren, wait.
If the killer really used a Royal typewriter, and if he subscribed to an Origami magazine, his name should be on both lists.
Well, Lauren, I mean, that's just an assumption, but... Yeah, I suppose.
His name is here somewhere. Help me, we're gonna find him.
The only guy whose name was on both lists died when he was 10. What are you gonna do now? Dig up his coffin, make sure he's dead?
I know it doesn't make any sense. Unless the killer was only using his name.
But why use the name of a kid who died 30 years ago?
Well, that's what we came to find out. The name is John Shepherd. It should be on a grave around here somewhere.
You never give up, do you?
Time to look for John Shepherd's grave. She's convinced she's onto something. And here's me, thinking we're wasting our friggin' time in this friggin' cemetery.
Excuse me. I'm looking for the grave of a young boy who died about 30 years ago. His name was John Shepherd. You wouldn't know where it is by any chance.
The children's graves are in the next plot.
Thanks.
This girl knows her mind all right. No point in trying to reason with her.
These flowers are fresh. Looks like someone's still tending the grave. Origami figures.
That's one hell of a coincidence.
Oh, youngin. That one I knew well.
You knew John Shepherd?
I've worked this graveyard nearly all my life. I remember what happened. It was in 77.
Did October. How you doing?
Drunk again.
What are we gonna do? It's pouring rain. We're gonna get soaked if we spend a day outside.
Well, at least we won't get beat. Little rain never hurt nobody. Come on, let's go play. Bet you can't catch me! Bitch can't do that. Jeez, you're in nothing but a slowpoke.
How are you doing?
Yeah. Yippee-ki-yay! To do this, it's too hard for you.
No chance, I can do it all right. Okay. Just watch. Wait for me!
Get a move on! Play hide and seek. You go and count to 20 and try to find me, okay?
One, two, three, four,
20.
Five, six, eight, 11, 15, 19, 20. Those cries. That's John's voice.
Help.
If he's just messing with me, he's gonna regret it.
I'm hurrying!
But the poor kid never did find any help. And his brother drowned in a pipe full of rainwater.
The boy that lived.
How are you?
What happened to him?
Well, how's your afternoon going?
All I know is he got separated from his parents. I think he got adopted. Well, looks like a storm's coming. I guess I better be getting home.
Christ, what a horrible story. John Shepherd drowned in the rain while holding his brother's hand. Do you think he could be the origami killer?
Come on, let's get back in the car.
There she goes again, surprising me. I don't usually like surprises. The kid died 30 years ago. Who's still tending the grave after all these years? There's nothing else for us here. Let's go. There's nothing else for us here. Let's go.
Wait.
What's the matter?
That man over there.
Yeah?
It's Charles Kramer.
Gordy's father? What's he doing here?
He's putting flowers on John Shepherd's grave.
Chef. Found my calling.
And then I get the hell out. If this Paco is one of the buddies of Dr. Death, I better watch my step. Paco Mendez, the guy the doc lent his apartment to. Not the kind of guy you take home to mom anytime soon. I'm gonna ask him a few questions. Bartender. Nothing against techno, trance, whatever music, but this stuff is really loud. Bartender. I don't know where I can find it. Reserved for select guests. Shouldn't be too hard to find.
not possible. Mr. Mendez has asked not to be disturbed.
Seems to like his girl sexy. Sexy in a kind of dumb way. I'm gonna have to rethink my strategy if I want to talk to Paco. I've gotta find someplace to change. Time to play the sexy girl.
Hey, sweetheart. The boss wants to invite you to his table.
Hey, Thanks for accepting my little invitation. You know around here, honey? I think I would have noticed you before. My name's Paco. Are you?
Madison. I'm Madison.
Ah, I like the way you move, Madison. You make me all hot under the collar.
Well, maybe we can continue this conversation somewhere more private.
Oh, cool, baby. Yeah, come with me.
I'll be right back. BRB.
This is no time to get squeamish. even if my legs do feel like they're about to give way. Everything's gonna be all right. Everything is gonna be all right.
So, welcome to my little kingdom.
You. Gross.
I'll take that. Just get in the way of good things, sweet cheeks. So, show me what you can do. Slowly. Take it all off.
Could I have a drink? You know, just a little drink to break the ice.
We already broke the ice, Mom. Let's get wet. Come on. Do your thing, girl.
Could we just talk first?
No. We don't need any more talking, baby. I all talked out. Now, show me what you can do.
I'm sorry. I think there's been a little misunderstanding. I'll just go. No harm done. Another time.
I think it is you who have misunderstood, honey. I'm tired of wasting my time. It's now or never. I never take never for an answer.
Yeah, I would have the same.
Think of something. There's got to be some way out of here. Do what it takes, Mad. Play for time. That's what I call kicking butt. You go, girl. Okay, act two. Let's hear Lover Boy sing. If you call out, I'll kill you. Got it?
Shit. What you want?
You rent an apartment on Marble Street. I want to know why.
An apartment? I don't know what you're talking about.
You haven't got the balls, lady. But you're gonna know balls when I gush up with you. You fucking bitch! I'm gonna kill you!
Boss? Is everything all right?
If you value those prized balls of yours, Paco, then it's time for you to talk.
What you doing? Stop it! Stop it!
I'm only getting started. How about some more?
I never set foot in that apartment. I gave the keys to some guy. He said he needed a place. He had money.
What was that guy's name?
I don't know his name, I swear. Shepard! His name is John Shepard! That's all I know, I swear it!
There, that wasn't so hard, was it? I really appreciated this romantic moment, but I gotta dash. See you next time, lover boy. How about that? You didn't do too badly now, did you, girl? Time to get out of here. I got a massive headache. The name he gave me, John Shepard. Could that be the name of the killer? Guess I'll soon find out.
I'm here to see Paco.
Paco? There ain't no Paco here, fella. Get lost.
Are you absolutely certain?
He's in his office. Take the stairs over there.
Oh, it's you. It's Garvin. I didn't hear you come in. A crazy beast came around here asking questions about the apartment on Marble Street. I don't know what you're doing down there, and I don't want to know. But whatever that shit is, it's beginning to draw attention. Look, I know you kept me out of prison.
But that fucking bitch nearly killed me. Everything you ask, I think my debt to you is paid.
Don't fuck around, man.
No, wait. I can still help you out. No. Don't kill me.
He could have killed me. Why didn't he? He could have killed me. Why didn't he? I seem to spend most of my time getting the shit kicked out of me. I'll end up a basket case if things keep going like this. That bastard nearly broke my neck. The suspect dead. Someone tries to kill me. On the right track, do you think? His coat pocket. I tore it off during the fight. Two receipts from the same gas station. Interesting. .45 caliber semi-automatic. Paco Mendez was no saint. His rap sheet reads like the telephone book. .45 caliber. Madison Page. What was the journalist doing here? Orchid pheromones. The fucking origami killer. The killer was looking for something. Bullet right between the eyes. Instant death. Madison Page. She may be a witness.
Hey, Brandy. How you doing? Doing pretty good, thank you. That's where to go. Homework. How How's that going? It has nothing on it. What kind of homework is it?
The bodyguard. He must have seen who did this. Gotta go. Need to think about all this. The killer may have left some clues in the office. Hacko knew the killer. That's why he was killed.
Business law. Okay.
It was too dark. It all happened so fast. Didn't have time to see his face.
Ethan, are you all right?
What do you think?
I killed a man. I had no choice. I had no choice.
You're not the origami killer, Ethan. You're not responsible for those murders. I can prove it.
That changes nothing. Saving Sean is all that matters now. I can't. Not now.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to. Anyway, I'm gonna go. I've no more business here. I'm going home. I hope he proves his innocence and finds his son alive. What was I thinking? How could I have ever believed that he felt something for me? He's trying to save his son. He's being chased by the police, and I'm trying to kiss him. What an idiot. Cops. They're looking for Ethan. It looks like a raid. Come on, what was the damn number? Motel. You've got to get out of here.
Come on, he's getting away. He's still on the move. Get him. He's making a run for it. He's on the balcony.
Where to go? You're surrounded.
Thank you.
Escape Master.
I'm sorry, Scott.
You should have listened to me, Mr. Shelby. I told you to drop the investigation.
Your son is a serial killer. How many people does he have to kill before you turn him in?
Gordy has his faults, but he's still my son. You have no children, Mr. Shelby. You can't possibly understand. You leave me no choice. Your investigation is over. For good.
Nothing's gonna work if I don't switch on that ignition.
I have saved her. Don't know.
I
Stay back! Don't come near me, or I'll shoot!
Fucking asshole.
Please, don't hurt.
Bastard! Lauren is dead! You fucking killed
her! Stop! Stop! I beg you!
Your idiot son killed all those kids, didn't he? He's the origami killer.
No! No! He's innocent! He's not a killer! Not a killer!
You're a fucking liar. Now tell me the truth.
No! No, please! Don't hurt me!
Last chance.
I don't know. I swear! I don't know anything! Stop! Stop! I beg you. I'll tell you. I'll tell you everything.
Gordy.
Hey,
Gordy
Dark.
Always wanted
How
his
you
fun,
doing, man?
You know? He wanted to...
How are you doing today?
Like the origami killer. He kidnapped that kid and he held him under the water for a little too long. It was an accident. An unfortunate accident. He just wanted to play. He told me everything. He was crying. He was so sorry for what had happened. Whatever he did. Gordy is my son.
Doing well, thanks. Well.
No one will miss him.
What?
That boy, Gordy killed. No one will miss him. Just street trash, like so many others. Oh.
You disgusting pile of shit. What about John Shepherd? Why did you put flowers on his grave?
I own the construction site where he died. I never forgot. I've been putting flowers on his grave for 30 years.
John had a twin brother. What happened to him?
I don't know. He was adopted, I think. His mother should know. Her name is Anne. Anne Shepherd. That girl, Lauren, she was just a whore. You'll forget her in no time. Come and work for me, Shelby. I'll pay you well. You'll be able to have all the girls you want.
Never say her name again. You hear me? Never.
My heart! I need my pills.
In that drawer.
There.
Saved my life.
I already regret it.
I wonder if that will have a different outcome doing that. I'm not sure. Ah. Kind-hearted.
John Shepherd died 30 years ago. Hope his mother has all the answers to this puzzle. Hello, I'm looking for Anne Shepherd's room.
Please sign the visitor's book. Are you a member of the family?
Yeah, you could say that.
Oh, she'll be pleased to have a visitor. No one ever comes to see her. With the Alzheimer's, she has trouble remembering things, but it'll still please her, you know. It's room 19 at the end of the corridor.
Thank you. Only a few hours left before Sean Mars dies. Hope I'm not wasting my time. Hello, Mrs. Shepherd.
Is it time for my pills already?
No, Mrs. Shepherd,
They're never on time with my pills. I don't know what they do here. In the other hospital, they were always on time. But here...
My name is Madison Page. I'm a journalist. I'd like to ask you some questions about your son.
I don't like this hospital. The food isn't very good, you know.
You had a son named John, and John had a twin brother.
Do you have my pills? It's time for my pills.
Try to remember, Mrs. Shepherd. John's twin brother was placed with a foster family after the accident. What was the name of the foster family?
I asked them for a television, you know. They said I didn't have enough money. It's a pity. I'm fond of television.
I know what happened at Carnaby Square. Do you remember?
Carnaby Square. I think I used to live there a long time ago. We didn't have much money at the time, you know. We had to make do with very little.
Do you remember John?
My Johnny. He is a good little boy, you know.
Your other son, Mrs. Shepherd, John's twin brother. What was his name?
What other son? I have no other son. I never had any children.
Hey, Jim McKeon. How you doing?
I think your son is in trouble, Mrs. Shepherd. He's done some terrible things. I need to find him. Do you understand?
Terrible things you're telling me. He never came to see me, can you believe it? In 10 years, never. No one forgets their mother, do they?
Mrs. Shepherd, your son may be linked to a series of murders. Perhaps you have some information that could help the investigation.
Are you a new nurse? Where are my pills?
Did you make these origami figures?
My little paper animals. They played with them for hours. I showed my boys how to make them, you know.
Yes, your boys, Mrs. Shepherd. John and... What was your other son's name again?
My other son? I only had one son. My little Johnny.
All right, no point in wasting my time. I won't learn anything more by staying here.
It'd take days, if not longer, to find the name of the family that adopted her son. Sean Mars would be dead by then. All right, no point in wasting my time. I won't learn anything more by staying here.
I love origami, but that's not my favorite one. Oh, you know how to do these little dogs, too. My children loved origami. I taught them how to do it. John loved the little dogs. He always wanted to call them Max. Max, Max, Max. All dogs with the same name. I was wasting my time telling him they couldn't all have the same name. But he always wanted his paper dogs Max. It's funny, isn't it?
Seems to be working. She's remembering stuff. Gotta find something else to show her. This woman might be the origami killer's mother. Must be some way to get her to remember. Does Mrs. Shepherd ever talk about her past?
It's not all very clear to her now. Sometimes she'll remember the oddest things, though. I suppose if she sees something that reminds her of her past.
Does she get many visitors?
She's been here for 10 years, and you're the first.
I'm looking for her other son. He was adopted. I mean, he's probably changed his name. Is there any official documentation on Mrs. Shepherd?
No, there's nothing really. Nothing about her family. I guess if her son was adopted, then she's the only one who could tell you about that. Sometimes, if you show her things, it seems to trigger a memory from her past. You might get it to remember.
Thanks for the advice. She said she loved flowers. But what kind?
Why they didn't let me pick that up in the first place? Better to save some time.
What a lovely orchid. My sons loved orchids. We used to grow them in the back. When John died, I laid orchids on his grave.
Are these your children, Mrs. Shepherd? John and his brother? Is that them?
They're good little boys. Their father never looked after them. Always drinking. They didn't have an easy life, you know. I cried when they told me. I'd already lost one of my children, and now they were taking away another one, you understand?
The foster family, Mrs. Shepherd. What was the name of the foster family that adopted John's brother?
They were really very nice people. I met them, you know. In the beginning, I used to go and see my little boy. And then I got sick and I couldn't go any longer. Perhaps he thought I'd forgotten him. He must have thought I didn't love him anymore.
His name, Mrs. Shepherd. What was his name?
But I loved him. If you only knew how much I missed him.
Please, Anne. His name. What was his name?
Come closer.
Right back. Had too much water. I'll be right back. Okay. I'm back.
The last origami figure. The last trial. The last origami figure. The last trial.
Last time I did this, I drank it, and I only got part of the letters, I think. So I don't know if I should take it, or if I should leave. I don't think I should leave, because they said that I could get him. I don't know. Should I take it? Take it or not?
Save Sean and die. Christ. He loses his father. But at least he's alive. Maybe it's the right thing to do. There's got to be another way. I can't kill myself to save my son. Kill myself to save Sean? That's ridiculous. I'll find some other way. I'm sure I can save him. He could be lying. Maybe I'll die as soon as I drink this, and then no one can save Sean. The cameras. He must be watching me. 1 hour to live. Just enough time to save Sean. Am I willing to die to save my son? There's no choice. I've got to do it. If I want to save my son. Poison. So, if I drink this, I'll be dead in an hour. And if I don't, I won't get the last letters. Nothing to lose. I've come too far to stop now.
I don't know. Okay, let's do it.
I did what I had to, Sean. Your dad's coming to save you.
Nowhere, and I'm out of time. Damn fucking shitty letters from this fucking address. Come on, there's gotta be a way to do this. Several different addresses fit these letters. God, they're scattered all over the city. I don't have time to check them all. I may only have time for one address. If Sean's not there, I'm done. It's a crapshoot. We've only got a few more hours left to save Sean Mars. There has to be a goddamn clue somewhere. It's probably staring me in the face. This kid's gonna die, and I'm going around in circles!
I'll pay. packed up and ready to go?
What are you talking about?
The investigation's over. We know who did it. We no longer need your services anymore, Norman. So you can ride your files all the way back to Washington. I'd be lying if I said I was gonna miss you.
The investigation isn't over. You have absolutely nothing on Mars.
Mars is guilty. Case closed. Anyway, it's no concern of yours now. You're off the case. So pack up and fuck off.
Blake, you are an unbalanced, psychopathic asshole.
I'll take that as a compliment. Honestly, I don't give a shit what you think. I found the origami killer. Everyone's happy. End of story. Have a nice trip back, Norman.
Killer's name is here. Somewhere in this data. I just have to find it. Find it before it's too late.
Oh, one last thing, sir. You should be careful not to overindulge in you know what. It can be dangerous. Very dangerous. It'll end up killing you if you're not careful. That would be most unfortunate, sir.
Harry was in record mode when I was fighting with the killer. Perhaps there's something on it. The sword was already in Paco's office. It's got nothing to do with the killer. watch. I'm sure I've seen this before somewhere. They give for promotions to lieutenant. The killer is a cop. Looks like the killer is a cop. Carta Blake! That would explain the dead-end investigation and his desire to frame Ethan Mars. Two receipts from the same gas station. Might be near the killer's home. Ugh, that doesn't get us anywhere. The killer lives in this zone. 342 people live around there. Not good enough. Gotta find a means of identifying the killer more precisely. The gun the killer left at the Blue Lagoon. Perhaps there's some way of tracing its history. Impounded in a police case 5 years ago, the gun is still supposed to be in police custody. Who checked it out? If not a cop. The killer is white, age between 30 and 45. He is intelligent, calm, and determined. An organized type. He has a car. He's probably employed, but his work allows him free time. Thank you. There is always a railroad line adjacent to where the bodies are found. And all the victims disappeared in the fall.
Something.
To get help fast. John's gonna drown. John's gonna drown. Mom's work is too far away. I'd never make it in time. This place is completely deserted. There's no one around to help. Hold on, bro. I'll find someone. Then we'll come back and save you. Dad, I've gotta get Dad.
The killer might be here. I better be careful. Let's hope he's not home. If he's in his apartment, I'll pretend I got the wrong floor. I should have informed the police. But I have no proof. Just the statement of an old woman who's lost her memory. The moment of truth. If Ann Shepherd gave me the right name, the origami killer lives here. I'm gonna be in deep shit if the killer comes back while I'm searching his apartment. No answer. If I can get in, I am sure I'll find something. What's your touch, girl? The origami killer's apartment. There must be something that'll tell me where Sean Mars is. I'll go through it, room by room, but there's bound to be some kind of clue. That's where the smell of burning comes from. Evidence going up in smoke. A cop's uniform. Always dressed a cop. That's why children went with him. He was dressed as a cop.
Okay, go back. See if we can solve it. I think. Or survive.
Shelby could come back at any moment. Sean Mars. The lunatic's been watching him drown. It's some kind of a well filling up with rain, slowly drowning him. There's not much time left. There must be something here showing where the well is.
Shit, it needs a password.
Brandy. Thank you, thank you.
So you found my little secret?
It's over, Scott. All those children killed just to find a father capable of saving his son?
Shut up!
You don't understand.
There's one child left. There might still be time to save him. Let him go. Do what your father couldn't do.
Get in there.
Got it. Max. The name John gave to his paper dogs when he was a child. What the hell is that? An address. It's gotta be where Sean Mars is. Hurry, there's no time to lose. Way too high. I'll kill myself if I jump. Gotta find something else.
Do I jump? No.
Thank you.
I know where Sean is. I've got to tell Ethan. It's Madison. I know where Sean is. He's at 852 Theodore Roosevelt Road. He's still alive. You can still save him.
I'm on my way.
Be careful, Ethan. The killer's still out there.
No one's gonna stop me from saving my son.
Sean! Sean! Can you hear me? Daddy's here. I'm gonna get you out of there. Gotta open this goddamn grate. Gotta find something, fast! God, Sean, answer me. Don't have me, son, please. Breathe. Gotta breathe. Oh, Sean. Oh, I thought you were gone.
Dad, I knew you'd come and save me.
Sean, listen. You are the best thing that ever happened to me in my life. I want you to know that whatever happens, I love you more than anything in the world. I'm not there. I took the poison an hour ago, and I'm not dead.
Ethan!
What are you doing here? Still looking for a story?
I know who the killer is, Ethan. I can prove your innocence.
Congratulations, Ethan. You succeeded. You're the father that I have been looking for all these years. The man capable of giving his own life to save his son.
You got what you wanted. I finished your trials. Now let us go.
I'm afraid that's not possible. Your lady friend knows my little secret. I don't intend to end my days in prison. I'm going to have to kill you both. I'm sorry. You earned my respect.
Thank you. relief this morning when the police announced that they had found Sean Mars alive more than 4 days after his disappearance. Mars had been imprisoned in a well by the man known as the Origami Killer. The successful resolution of this case was made possible only by the bravery of Ethan Mars, who the police believed at one point to be the killer. It is no doubt due to his great courage and tenacity that he succeeded in foiling the plans of the Origami Killer. The police commissioner presented him with an official apology today. Our main headline today, it is reported that the police have identified the man thought to be the Origami Killer. Scott Shelby, 48, is a former police lieutenant who claimed to be a private eye hired by the families of the killer's victims. Shelby was killed during a massive police operation, but further details have not yet been released to the public.
Oh, you want the rain down there, Brandy? It's too cold to be raining here.
Is this where we're gonna live now?
Only if you really, really want to. Or we can keep on looking until we find something you like.
It doesn't matter where we live, as long as we're together.
I will never let anyone or anything separate us again. We're stuck with each other, kiddo. Like glue.
Can I choose where my room is?
Sure thing, champ.
You like the rain? I like warm rain. I don't like cold rain. We always get cold rain up here.
All right, then I think we can stay here.
About to receive a Pulitzer Prize for her remarkable series of investigative articles about the Origami Killer case. Showing incredible courage, her daring intervention led to the arrest of the country's most wanted criminal and saved the life of a little boy. This evening, I welcome a woman who might well be the true definition of a heroine for the ages, Madison Page. Good evening. Thank you for agreeing to talk with us. Now, you've been described as being both determined and tenacious. Two qualities, no doubt, that were needed to see you through the dark hours of this unbelievable story. Were you afraid at any time?
More journalists like you, Miss Page. It's a good thing you were there to catch that bastard.
Thank you. What's your name?
Vincent. Excellent investigation, Miss Page. You are one brave lady. You deserve a better adversary. Somebody more ferocious.
He's being buried in 2 days in some godforsaken hole in the back end of beyond near Washington. I have to attend as a matter of protocol.
I'll pass. Jane and I didn't see eye to eye on much.
No problem. I understand.
Hey, sir, I still have his glasses. What should I do with them?
Well, we won't be needing them again. Do whatever you want with them.
don't want to see them again.
I'm a father too.
Thank you.
Already, that was the game. We into the Dawn of Vietnam, so that's good. This next game I'm going to have to continue on with is going to be Ori, but I'm going to have to go ahead and figure out, probably off stream, how to get past one part that I can't get past. So, thank you for everybody who watched. Appreciate it. I'm going to go offline for now. Put in some lurking in some other streams. Get ready for dinner and whatnot. So, hope you guys have a great night. And we will catch you later. Have a good one, guys. Bye for now.